Haunted, Stories of the Supernatural. Anna Cropper stars in Walk on the Water by Rosemary Timperley, adapted for radio by Derek Hoddenott.
Lovely, dear.
It's the best sandcastle on the beach.
Hello.
Hello. What do you think of my sandcastle?
I think it's a lovely sandcastle.
I made it all myself.
Did you now? You're very clever.
Who are you?
Rachel! Rachel, dear!
Yes?
It's time for tea. Now, come along, darling. You'll have to leave your sandcastle until tomorrow.
Well, it won't be here tomorrow. The sea will have come and taken it away.
Well, then you'll have to build a new one. Come along now. Daddy's waiting.
Did you see the man?
What's that, dear? Now, don't forget your spade.
The man I was talking to just now.
When?
Just now, before you called me.
I didn't see you speaking to anyone. But whoever it was, I hope you didn't talk to him. You know what I've told you about strangers.
I only said hello and asked who he was.
Well, what did he say?
Nothing. He went away.
I wonder what he was up to.
Nothing. He only said hello. He said he liked my sandcastle, that's all.
Now, look, Rachel, we can't be watching you all the time. We let you onto the beach because we trust you to be sensible. Now, if this man or anyone else comes near you again when you're alone, you simply come and tell us at once. Is that clear?
I liked him.
That has nothing to do with it. Anyway, you can't possibly decide you like someone just on one meeting. Now, come along. We mustn't be late for tea. Rachel?
Yes, Mummy?
Some cake, dear. There's that chocolate one left. You know how you like chocolate cake.
No, thank you.
Is anything the matter?
No. I was just thinking.
Sorry I'm late, Beatrice. Oh, dear, that Mrs. Delaney.
Yes, I was wondering where you'd gone to, Henry.
You know what she's like.
Other than that she's a guest like ourselves, no.
She likes to pass the time of day, and that means at least half an hour's gossip.
You should be firmer, Henry. We've practically finished our tea.
I'm sorry, dear. But she told me something rather distressing. Apparently a man on the beach this afternoon. She thought he was simply going for a swim. He went into the water and...
Do you mean...
Did Mummy tell you about the man I saw on the beach, Daddy?
You shouldn't have been listening, Rachel. Daddy was telling me something private.
Sorry. Anyway, I liked him. He had a kind face. I think I'll spend the rest of the holiday looking for him.
Well, Rachel, has he asked you?
What do you mean, Mother?
Oh, darling, you know what I mean. Stop teasing. Are you engaged to Peter?
Yes. Oh. Yes, I am.
Oh, let me see the ring. Oh, it's beautiful, darling. Congratulations.
You're really pleased, then?
Oh, of course I am. Your father will be too. You know he likes Peter.
Oh, he's been mumbling about us being too young.
Oh, he doesn't mean it. All fathers hate losing their daughters. It's a well-known fact. After all, you're 21, officially. You're on your own.
Oh, Mother, I do love him.
Oh, of course you do. And he's doing so well. He's got excellent prospects. Oh, that reminds me, we must have a celebration, an engagement party, this Saturday.
Oh, not this Saturday, please. Can you make it next week? Peter's taking me to see Swan Lake at Covent Garden on Saturday.
Not ours, is it?
No, darling, it's the number 42. There'll be another tram in a minute or two.
Hurry along, please.
Enjoy it.
What's that, Peter?
I said, did you enjoy it?
Loved it. You?
Yes.
Really?
Don't you believe me then?
I don't think you'd like ballet, not really.
Oh, it's all right, I suppose.
Oh, I thought it was beautiful. Thank you, Peter.
As long as you enjoyed yourself, then so did I.
Oh, I love you.
Shh, people will hear.
Don't be silly. Anyway, I don't care.
Hello.
Hello.
What did you say, darling?
What?
I thought you said something.
No.
You all right?
Yes, why?
You've suddenly gone pale.
No, I'm tired, that's all.
Here's our tram. Are you sure nothing's the matter?
Hmm?
Seen someone you know?
Yes. I thought I had. Must have been mistaken, that's all. Well, Daddy, here I am. What do you think?
You look beautiful. Really beautiful. It's time.
The car here?
Yes.
Better get going, haven't we? Don't want to keep the bridegroom waiting.
Nervous?
Worse than nervous. I'm not sure.
You can still pull out if you don't feel right about it.
Oh, Daddy, I love you. I'm okay, really. It's just stage fright, that's all.
Stage fright? I'm practically paralysed with fear. It isn't me getting married. Well, you know what your mother's like. She had to have all the trimmings. You're like me. You don't want fuss. A quiet registry office. That would have suited you, wouldn't it?
Come on. It's my big day.
It's like marrying your mother all over again.
Careful, Rachel. Mind your dress.
I feel like a film star. All these people.
All right.
Yes.
Well, here goes.
It's a long way to the church door.
Hello.
What's that, dear?
Just hello.
Hello, my darling. Bear up. Soon be over now.
Please, Peter.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to be. It's me, that's all.
You're tired?
It's been a hectic day. There's so much to see in Venice, and I find it difficult to relax, that's all.
You love me, don't you?
Oh, Peter, it's nothing to do with you.
Are you sure?
Of course I am. It's been the most marvellous 2 weeks of my whole life.
I'm glad. It's just... Well, I love you so much, Rachel.
I love you too, darling.
Then what's the matter?
Nothing.
There is, I'm sure.
Please, Peter, go to sleep. Please, darling. I'm just tired, that's all.
If you're sure...
Everything's all right. Honestly. Good night.
Good night.
I've seen him every day since I've been here. Hello, he says. Hello, I say. He has such a kind face. I think he loves me. And I love him.
Peter, sit down, for God's sake.
It'll probably be hours yet.
Oh, I'm sorry. I hope to God she'll be all right.
Well, of course she will. Now, please sit down. She's only having a baby.
Only? Things could go wrong.
Well, it's very rare. But anyway, she's in the best place.
You're not the first man to become a father, Peter.
All right, all right.
That's better. Let's hope Rachel's taking it more calmly than you.
That's it, my dear. Push. Again.
Oh, my God, please.
Good. Good, good girl. It's a boy. Beautiful boy. Nurse.
Oh, thank God. Thank God. Oh, dear. Is he all right?
He's perfect. Give us a few minutes and we'll have you ready to see your husband. Well, now, how are you feeling, Rachel, eh?
Sore.
Nurse has brought you your baby.
Oh, thank you.
That's it. We'll let your husband in now, but only for a few minutes. I'll be around to see you later.
Thank you, Doctor.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, old girl.
Let me see him.
What?
The baby, darling.
We're parents.
Billingsley 42231.
Rachel?
Hello, Mother.
I thought you were coming over this evening.
We are.
Babysitter not arrived?
Neither babysitter or husband.
Where is he, then?
God knows. He left the office ages ago. I was about to ring the babysitter to find out what's happened to her.
I get the feeling you're not coming.
You may well be right.
Is anything the matter?
Of course there's something the matter. I'm angry. I'm bloody annoyed, that's what.
How are the children?
They're fine.
You ought to get yourself a tonic.
Thank you, Mother, but I don't need your advice.
Oh, look, darling, since you had Melanie, you've not been the same.
Good night, Mother.
Please, Rachel, I'm serious. You said yourself the second birth wasn't as difficult as the first. You said, in fact, that it was wonderful.
So it was.
Then why has it changed
you? It hasn't changed me.
You don't seem content anymore. I noticed it the first week you were out of hospital. Postnatal depression that would wear off, but doesn't seem to.
Mother, I shall put the phone down in a moment.
Don't you dare. Now, I've spoken to your father about it, and he's going to speak to Peter. It's not that we want to interfere.
Oh, my God. What in the hell's the matter with me? Second birth was wonderful. That's because he was there. He helped me. He took me in his arms and lifted me up and up.
Mrs. Bannister?
Yes. Yes, officer. What is it?
Your husband, madam. I'm afraid he's had an accident.
Hello.
What?
Rachel, did you say something?
Hello.
Hello.
Well, Rachel, what are you going to do now you're retiring?
Well, Mr. Fredericks...
Please, my dear, we're alone.
Well, John, I don't know. I expect I shall become one of those lonely old widows. You see, trudging the high streets in the rain.
It doesn't have to be like that, you know.
Oh, please. You promised all those years ago that you'd never discuss it again.
But it's different now. You were a young widow then, with two small children. And the war. I made the mistake of asking you to marry me too soon. But now your children are grown up. Your son's in Canada. Your daughter never comes to see you. You're alone.
Please, John, you don't need to remind me. Anyway, I like being alone. I've got used to it. Besides, I've got a comfortable house, a pension. I can always come and see you, and you can come and have tea with me as often as you like. Believe me, my dear, I shall be perfectly all right.
I want you to have this.
Oh, no.
This is personal, from me. Nothing to do with the firm, you understand. A present from me to you for being the best secretary I've ever had.
Flattery will get you everywhere, Mr. Fredericks. John.
Open it.
Oh, that's beautiful. Honestly, I couldn't.
Yes, you can. I insist.
It must have cost you an awful lot of money.
Please wear it. Always.
It's the most beautiful cameo I've ever seen.
To remember me by. Remember me, Rachel, please.
Memories. That's all that's left. Oh, I'd better make some tea, I suppose.
Hello.
It's you.
Hello.
I don't believe in you anymore. Do you hear? I don't believe in you anymore! I know what you're going to say, Doctor.
Do you?
What all doctors say at my time of life. You're getting old.
Well, it's true, I'm afraid.
So?
What do you mean?
What's the remedy?
There is no remedy for old age, Mrs. Bannister. At least, not one that's been invented as yet. All we can do is help you along the road.
Help you along the road? I like that, Doctor. I like that very much.
Well, at least you can smile.
In a moment, you'll be telling me that I need a change.
As a matter of fact...
Oh. No, Doctor, please.
Listen to me, Mrs. Bannister. You spend too much time on your own in that house of yours. You need to get out and meet people.
I do meet people.
Well, you shouldn't have retired when you did then. You're a woman who needs to keep her mind occupied.
I didn't want to be known as the old lady any longer. That's what the other secretaries were calling me. The old lady. She came with the furniture.
All right, all right. But a change of surroundings, a breath of sea air would do you good. And you might meet someone. Who knows?
Meet someone?
Well, yes. You may be in your 60s, Mrs. Bannister, but you're still an attractive woman.
That's very kind of you, Doctor, but you're quite wrong. Attractive people are those who are full of life.
That's why I want you to go away. Please take my advice. Have a week by the sea. Make the world go away, hmm? What do you say?
All right. I'll take your advice.
Good.
And I think I know where to go. There's a little boarding house I went to with my parents when I was about, 8 or 9. It has a long stretch of beach in front of it. I'll go there. I had a happy time there. I made my first really big sandcastle there.
I hope no one's watching. An old woman like me pretending to be a child again. Nothing more sillier, I imagine.
Hello.
It's you again. Hello. I'm glad you came.
So am I.
Good heavens.
What's the matter?
I've just remembered. We must be about the same age now, you and I.
Did I trouble you very much in the past?
Sometimes. But you helped me too. I'm sorry I turned against you.
And I'm sorry if I ever troubled you.
Why did you? Trouble me.
I wanted you. I still do.
I feel too sad and finished for anyone to want me.
That's why I can come so close to you.
There was that time in the hospital when Melanie, my second baby, was born. You came close to me then. You touched me, took me in your arms. Oh, that journey into the sky.
It was a mistake. I acted too soon. Come for a walk.
All right. Where shall we walk to?
Out there.
There?
That's right.
We can't walk into the water.
Not into it, my dear. On it.
But that's impossible.
No, it isn't. I promise you. I walked this way all those years ago. Like you, I thought it wouldn't be possible to walk on the water. I wanted to die. So I walked into the water until it was right over my head. Or so I thought. There was pain, blackness, terror, a sort of explosion. And I thought, now, death forevermore. And then I suddenly found myself standing on the sand again, watching a little girl building her sandcastle. You were the most beautiful person I had ever seen. I loved you on sight. You loved me, too. But you were very young. I couldn't really approach you, except to say, hello.
That's all you ever did until today?
No, you did say, who are you?
You didn't answer.
I couldn't. I didn't know the answer. Then.
You went away.
Influences kept separating us. I couldn't always reach you.
When I wanted to reach you, you used to disappear.
I couldn't help it. There's a time and place for everything. One can't go against these influences. They're stronger than we are. But at this moment, they are with us. I shan't disappear again.
You would if I turned my head away and dismissed you from my mind.
Perhaps. But please don't. Never turn away from love. Come along, my darling. Walk with me. Here. Take my hand.
But there's nothing there.
Never mind. Come. Walk with me.
I'm coming.
Come along, then. Walk with me.
I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming.
Thank you.
Walk on the Water by Rosemary Timperley was adapted by Derek Hodinott. We've another tale from our series Haunted Tomorrow, The Dream Woman by Wilkie